So Dogecoin crashed a bit more than other cryptos today. In this video, I'll talk about what led to it and if it's all over for Dogecoin or not. Hello guys and welcome back to Crypto Fire, where we talk about Dogecoin, cryptocurrency, and investing. So Dogecoin's price has dropped more than 30% in the last month due to a massive sell-off. While Bitcoin was able to get on track, Dogecoin wasn't. And even today, it took a bigger beating than Ethereum and some other altcoins. The simple fact is that the altcoins aren't moving as quickly as Bitcoin. With a small 0.73% increase in the last 24 hours, Ethereum's value has remained relatively unchanged. After a decent increase last week, it started the week at around 3.7K. And we can say the same about Cardano, Ripple, Polkadot, and Uniswap. They have all had a tough start to the week, just like Dogecoin did. Now, you might be wondering why Shiba Inu is rising while all the other altcoins are falling. I'll come back to that in a minute. But first, let's try to understand why Doge and other altcoins are falling. So during a recent interview with Bill Miller, the founder of Miller Value Partners pushed for the rise of Bitcoin but expressed skepticism about several altcoins. He basically said that there are 10,000 tokens floating out there. The chances of more than a handful of them being worthwhile is very, very small. Bitcoin, Ethereum, and a few others are probably going to be around for a while. My point is that institutions are getting wary of altcoins like Doge because they think that they're a pump-and-dump scheme. While it may be true for some shitcoins, I think Doge is right up there with ETH, Cardano, and Bitcoin. This is because there's a lot on the cards for Dogecoin this year. We heard big companies like AMC accept it, and its adoption and use cases are only going to increase when the new Doge upgrade comes out. Elon Musk talked about it too, about how it'll reduce Dogecoin's transaction fees by 100x. Now, people are losing faith in Doge because they aren't aware of these future developments. And to be fair, it's taking a really long time for the devs to roll out the new upgrade for Doge. Despite that, I believe that it's time to have diamond hands for Doge because Elon is still going to back it. It still has the new upgrade coming out for it, and many more companies will still look at Dogecoin as a great payment method, as Mark Cuban last month. Now, coming back to why the altcoins crashed, another reason was the rumor that the Bitcoin ETF is going to be approved very soon. So, the institutional investors and many retail investors are pouring in more money into Bitcoin than they are in altcoins. The latest report from CoinShares explains it pretty well. It said that Bitcoin investment products dominated the altcoins with inflows of $225 million last week. So, that just tells you the mood of the market right now. People are dumping their altcoins for Bitcoin because they hope it'll make them rich this month. Now let's talk about why people are dumping Doge for Shiba Inu. It's because they believe that Robinhood is going to come out with its huge Shiba announcement this month. And there are hundreds of news articles coming for Robinhood and Shiba Inu every single day that talk about this. And this is creating a certain FOMO effect, which is bringing in people from Dogecoin to Shiba Inu. There isn't a big catalyst or big news that we're waiting for Dogecoin this month, and so people have forgotten about the big things for Dogecoin this year. As I said, I think it's time to have diamond hands and not forget about Elon's support, Dogecoin's upcoming upgrade, and the Doge One mission. With that said, I do expect Dogecoin to fall even more in the short term. So if you want to be patient with it, you can wait for it to get back on track when the upgrade comes out. Or you could just sell it to accumulate more Shiba and Bitcoin. In any case, I'd like to remind you that I'm not a financial advisor and this isn't financial advice. So you should definitely do proper research before investing anything into crypto. Now, we still have to talk about Bitcoin since Dogecoin's 30-day correlation with it is still at 0.7. So it's highly likely that in the long term, Dogecoin will follow its trajectory again. So Bitcoin has finally crossed 56,000 to start the week as altcoins struggled to register gains. It is now aiming for 60K as the number of active entities rises and the price chart shows an impending bull cross. According to data provided by Glassnode, while Bitcoin has increased 30% this month, user activity on the network has climbed 19% to 284K. Also, the average BTC transaction size has surpassed 1.3 Bitcoin. Since March 2021, long-term holders have dramatically boosted their Bitcoin holdings too. Long-term holders have added 2.37 million Bitcoin to their holdings in the last 7 months. Also, as per another expert analysis, Bitcoin price may hit an all-time high by November. If the latest price data is correct, Bitcoin will hit new all-time highs this month and at least 72K in November. The most recent bullish Bitcoin price projection strengthens the argument for a breakout, but still, a regression might lead to a trip to 45K. Now, as I said, I think this is unlikely after the new Bitcoin ETF inevitably gets approved this month. Now, coming back to data, despite the latest spike, Bitcoin miners appear to be holding off on selling Bitcoin. The miner reserve is a metric that displays the total amount of Bitcoin that miners have in their wallets at any one time. A rise in the metric's value indicates that miners believe the coin's worth will rise in the near future. And so this is really bullish because a majority of these miners know a lot more than we do. And so if they expect a rally, it's likely that we'll see it soon. Now, let's talk about some news for crypto adoption and rising use cases. Recently, Ted Cruz has spoken out about Bitcoin mining in his state, proposing some novel solutions to existing issues. He said that Bitcoin has the ability to solve many of the state's problems. And then another news about adoption was that Switzerland is undertaking a project that might make Bitcoin one of the country's reserve assets. Last week, the group revealed plans to launch a popular federal initiative to add Bitcoin to the Swiss federal constitution by gathering 100,000 signatures. And another great news for crypto was that Bitcoin is now on the table for the Aussie homebuyers. It says here that Australians can now buy a house using Bitcoin, as Lloyds Auctions Australia has announced it will accept Bitcoin for real estate transactions in online auctions. Moving on, there is another bad news for crypto from China. According to recent insider reports, the Chinese judiciary is now working on legislation to convict and imprison those involved in crypto-related activities. Now, this is the kind of news that could spread a lot of FUD in the market. But we have to understand that the China ban is not that bad anymore, and all the cryptos are slowly recovering. Now, let's come back to Doge and other the entire crypto market. I know that Dogecoin is still falling despite Bitcoin's and some other altcoins rise, but we have to remember that Bitcoin and Dogecoin's 30-day price correlation is still pretty high at 0.7. So I think Bitcoin can definitely take Doge up with it too, but we have to be a bit more patient with it. Still, I'd love to know where you think we're headed from here, so let me know in the comment section below. And this is it for today's video. Thanks for watching till the end. If you enjoyed it, please consider liking and sharing it with your friends. Also, please subscribe to the channel and turn on post notifications for daily videos on Dogecoin and cryptocurrency. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Goodbye, take care.